Hey yo, check this out. This is interesting. So I'm going through some of these books that we picked up at the different sales and rebagging them, boarding them. And I came across this one, Silk Spectre number 3, and it was in a bag. But then when I opened the bag up, man, it had plastic. It looked like a mailer. Look, this board was in it and it looked like a mailer. But look at that. Can you see that? Can you see the plastic? This plastic is like stale. It's like a bag just disintegrated. I don't know if you can see that, but there's some still. Can you see it on the desk? I have never come across this before, and it's on the, it's not stuck to the, can you see that? Look at that, man. Just it's like it's shattered. It's crazy. See that? Unreal, man. You never know what you're gonna find in these things. But anyways, yeah, look. It's crazy. All right, on with the show. Hit the music. Getting you situated, have a seat, pull a seat, take a load off. Hey guys, I got my LCS haul for August 14th, 2019. Outside and enjoying the beautiful weather while it lasts. So let's take a look at this shit, see what's up. So guys, I don't know, somehow this I didn't even know this existed. It was a freebie. It was the 2019 Young Guns sketchbook from Marvel. And let's see if you guys can see that pretty good. A lot of cool artwork in there, man. You can see there's Pepe Larraz. I really digging some of his stuff recently. And Del Mundo did that Venom number 2 variant. I really dig where he's like hanging upside down and picking his teeth. A lot of really talented artists, and I guess they do deserve their own freebie book from Marvel. I don't know, little promotional thing, so snatch that up. And then while I was waiting, he was ringing somebody else up. There's a guy ahead of me when he opened. So I looked in his dollar bin real quick, and laying right on top, Thor God of Thunder number 18. Pretty sure I don't have it. Now there is a bunch of books that from these sales that I didn't put in my CLZ app. If you guys are familiar with the CLZ app, it's like cataloging for your comics. So I grabbed it. It was a buck, and I'm pretty sure I don't. And the same with this, number 16 of Amazing Spider-Man. These sweet Alex Ross covers. Almost positive I've never seen that one before, so playing catch up with that as well. Now, I was digging in his back issues because I was like, man, I wonder if he has any of those old Turtles with the Jessica or Thor's, Jane Foster's, which I didn't find. But while I was digging through the tees, I found this, True Believers number 1. Only has one little spinal, it's not even a tick really, it's just like a little crease. But I was sure if I had to, I could get it pressed out. But this is the first appearance. This is like, I think it's like a techno symbiote. So it's definitely a symbiote. So I grabbed that up. That's only a second copy I have. The other one I think I paid cover price for in a back issue bin. But this one was $2. That's a win. Now, on to this week's subscriptions. So I got Detective Comics 1009 cover B, the Year of the Villain variant. Actually, I think that might be the A cover. No, I think it's a B cover. Ah, whatever. It's Year of the Villain. It is a B cover. And then I grabbed the, of course, subscription-wise, the ASM 27. Guys, check this out, man. First of all, this looks like an homage to, I think, an 80s, it might be a Ron Frenz ASM cover. I would say it's around 270s. Looks a lot like that. But this is the new Sinister Six, all female. So you guys know how Marvel is promoting the diversity in the females. Again, not a bad thing. So you never know when they're going to show up, so it's kind of a cool key to have. I also asked him to order me one of these, second printing of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 95. I am willing to bet you guys all know that the 95 is the first appearance of Jessica as a female turtle. It's the first in continuity female turtle, I believe. So Jessica, I think her first appearance was in 51 and 52 as a foot soldier, and now she is a turtle. Believe it or not. So it seems like there's a lot of these second prints, and I would assume there's not very many first prints. If you guys can find that first print, scoop it up for, you know, don't spend $1 million on it, but I would definitely grab it up if you can find it for a reasonable price. Now, Venom, number 16. He knows I gotta eat up all these second prints on Venom, because again, that's my main collection, and I'm a sucker. So I buy all these second prints of these. Again, they just use the interior artwork mostly, but they do change the cover, so gotta have it. So owned. I grabbed up a Silver Surfer Black number 3. You guys know the hype. This has had some lead into some symbiote stuff and crazy artwork. It's like being on LSD inside a trip machine while you're in Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. So grab that up. And this is an oddball one. I have the other one, number 8, all the hype around surrounding number 8. So I grabbed this Captain Marvel number 9. And honestly, it was just kind of a combination. I saw the cover, I was like, dude, that's a badass cover. And then it's pretty unique. And then I was like, you know what, after all that hype, I'm just grabbing it. So I grabbed it. I don't know. And then there's another one, Second Coming number 2. That's what she said. Mr. Jesus riding the back of a Superman type figure. I didn't get to read this yet, but I'm very interested in it. It seems like my kind of satire. And then lastly, I grabbed a Catwoman, well, actually asked him to order this for me, Catwoman number 14, the Art Germ variant. Doesn't look like a typical Art Germ. It's actually, looks like it's based off the Batman animated series from the 90s, which is sweet as hell, and it's really just a nice, beautiful cover. Kitty Cat on the cover, and it's a win, man. So that's the haul again for August 14th, 2019. Thanks for joining me. Like, comment, subscribe, please, by all means. And let's move on to the next segment. Booyah! Nerdfingers, Davey Nerdfingers, and polypropylene.
What's up, everybody?
And Dave went to a local con. It's actually like kind of like a celebrity con. And you had a little bit of a haul. You didn't bring everything.
Yeah, I brought my heavy hitters. Like I was telling Janine, the ones that heavily hit my wallet.
Yes, so.
Brought some big ones. Check me out here, Vanilla Fingers. All right, so
is this your shit right here, huh?
Yeah, right. Yeah, Twitter.
Did you do Absolute Carnage? Is that Absolute Carnage?
Yeah. I'll put it around here again, so y'all can see. Cool. Absolute Carnage Week.
All right. First of all, hold on. Let's do this.
Okay.
We did the old switcheroo, and we did pickups for each other. So these are the two I got for you, and you picked up two for me. And so, wow. The two you picked up for me was Red Sonja and Vampirella Meet Betty and Veronica, the Robert Hack cover of number 3. Check that out. Isn't that badass?
Oh, I like it.
So, instead of sugar, blood sugar.
What?
Blood sugar.
And then also, when I saw this, I was like, oh my God. I don't know who did the artwork. It says Royce, but it's Elvira, Mistress of the Dark, number 8. But isn't that cool as hell? That's like really, yeah, I think that's really nice.
It was the only one they had when I got there. Oh, man. Wow. So I made sure.
Not a lot of them out there, huh?
So
I grabbed those up, and then I grabbed you your two.
And which was Star Wars number 70, Greatest Moments. If y'all remember Return of the Jedi.
Spoiler alert!
Cool.
Too soon. Hashtag too soon.
Yeah. And the other one was Future Foundation number 1.
The new Future Foundation series.
Oh.
Kind of cool. It's like a mixture of Power Pack and Fantastic Four Kids and Dragon Man.
I was wondering who that was on there.
He used to be a villain. I guess he's a good guy now. I don't know.
So what'd you get? What happened to the con? So we know it's a celebrity con. Did you meet any celebrities or see any or anything?
No, I just went and hit the comics. It's pretty much
really?
It. I tried to not look at the Funko Pops and just went straight comics. This time.
I did see where they're coming out with an Elvira one.
Elvira Funko Pop.
Oh, that would
Pop.
Be really cool.
Yeah,
that's cool.
That'd
be really cool.
Yeah, I did see that the other day. They're coming out with an Elvira Funko.
Instead
Pop.
Of having a big head, is it big boobs and then no head? Is it?
It's the same, but I mean it's yeah.
We need the proportions accurate. I need accurate proportions.
I'm gonna have to look that up. Because I don't remember.
Bobble
you know.
Boobs. Boobles.
Was,
Booble heads.
It was pretty cool.
Does the head bobble or something else?
So the lonely Virgil didn't stalk you this time.
No, I didn't see him.
That's
this
one
time,
of the
actually.
That's one of the best ones I remember from the con was Virgil from NWO WWF.
Ted DiBiase's sidekick.
Yeah, he of course has a sign that says Ted DiBiase. He's supposed to join him, but he never shows up. Uh-huh. But yeah, he wouldn't leave Dave alone. He was stalking him, man.
Oh,
he wanted that money. He had a mark.
Oh,
yeah, he did. Every time I walk by, I had to avoid that.
Dave killed. He's like, I gotta get away from Virgil. He won't leave me alone. You should have threw him $10 and told him not to talk to you.
Yeah, here, leave me alone, buddy, here. All right, so.
So what do we do? What are we doing here?
Okay, so a couple things real quick before some of my heavy hitters was I got a couple mail calls, and a
Ooh.
Buddy of mine picked this up for me. It's Major X Zero, Dave's favorite, Rob
Whoa,
Liefeld.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
And the other one was the SDCC Comic-Con Venom.
Number 16. That's cool, man.
Yes.
I got one of those, too, just recently.
Yeah, very
cool.
Mm-hmm.
I like
that. That was neat, man. Mm-hmm.
I like that better than regular cover. That's another one that has the black and white that I like better.
Yeah, I do like that one better than the regular cover.
And then what? What do you got here?
What else I got is my other mail call was... this one was the second print of the first appearance of...
It's the first female turtle. It's Jessica as a female turtle.
That's it. Yes.
Yeah.
And the other one was the first appearance of Star.
Star.
Captain Marvel.
Is that the A cover for that, huh?
Yeah.
I've only
it's
seen
the
that.
Carnageized A cover as well.
Yeah, I have the Carnageized. That's the variant. That's the B cover. But I didn't even know what the A cover looked like. Okay, cool.
Yeah, I remember seeing that day on Wednesday when I went in. I was like, I passed it up.
I pre-ordered it just because I thought it was one of the best Carnageized covers I saw. And I was like, you know what? That's a really nice cover. And I'm doing a cover buy, I guess. And I'm glad I did. So, and then what
as well as the 95, I had also picked up 96.
Okay.
Which is the first full appearance of her as a new turtle.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
And what recently came out was Archie vs. Predator number 2, number 1. Here is the first series of the number 1.
Oh, he's got.
Oh my!
Junkhead, what's going
That's
on
cool.
there? Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, I saw that.
Does he have a spine hanging there? No. That's cool though.
Now this one, when I saw it, I figured the plot and the storyline would be much like her movies, very
yeah,
well written.
Yeah, I see you got it wrapped in plastic there.
So
wrapped in plastic for protection.
So I thought that would
very,
be very interesting.
Ironically,
very,
from Virgin Comics.
Very well written.
Yeah, very well written. I can't wait to get home with it.
I have some time alone with that.
So, another box that I found, a guy had all these that were half off. So this one...
Speaking of things being half off.
Oh. So, this one, I saw recently that Liefeld's trying to get The Rock to play this character. Here.
The Rock.
Oh, no.
That was my Mr. McMahon imitation.
Yeah.
The Rock.
Let's see if we can get somebody else to play that character.
And this is also the second Deadpool.
Oh, second appearance of Deadpool. Guys, anytime I see that for like $5 or less, I pick it up because it's like really undervalued, man. But first appearance of Weapon 10. That's what it is.
Okay.
Yeah.
And let's see here. What order am I going next? Next will be from this one other table. I was grabbing these to fill up just issues I needed and wanted.
Cool.
Here, much like the other issue that I showed recent, was the Captain Marvel number 8.
That's the B, the variant, the Carnageized variant.
The Carnageized variant.
Such a nice cover.
Yeah, that's nice.
It's pretty.
And this one here is what is the first Ghost Spider title? Spider-Gwen when it changed to Ghost Spider.
Is okay.
I believe so. As well as Carnageized.
Yes. Might be the first Carnageized Spider-Gwen. I don't know. Cool.
And this one here, which is the Jane Foster Thor series, the number 8. This is where it's revealed that it is Jane Foster.
Okay. Cool.
And
those books are all hot right now because of the announcement for MCU.
Yeah.
Thor God of Thunder number 5.
I don't know if that's a key or not. I don't know, but it's still a cool issue.
Mm-hmm.
But it's got Gore the God Butcher on it. That's cool.
And then the last table where I spent some of the most money, and I really wanted these issues. All right, I don't know which one to show first. I'm excited.
Show Spidey.
I'll show Spidey. This is Amazing Spider-Man 24, Carnageized.
Okay, cool.
Very cool. And
he's Carnageized?
The Carnageized.
Oh, logo. The logo. The logo. Okay.
And then, being that it's Absolute Carnage week, I had to get one, and it was the what did they call this?
That isn't the codex. It's like 1 in 50, maybe.
It's a codex.
It is a codex. Okay, yeah. 1 in 50 codex variant of Absolute Carnage.
Carnage.
That's nice.
I actually pre-ordered
nice.
One of those. It's coming in the mail.
Really?
Yeah.
That's nice.
I love that artwork on there.
And this is a comic I never thought I'd see, and I thought it was a good price, so I went ahead and got it. It was a first print of Immortal Hulk number 1.
Cool.
Oh, wow.
Do you remember, Janine, do you remember how many of those they had left over at that one place? We used to see those all the time, man.
Yes.
Really?
There was piles of them, man.
Really?
Swear to God. And I was like, I don't need a number 1.
Get out. That's wild.
In fact, he had piles of all of them except for number 2 for a long time.
Yeah, for a while.
And
I feel like I should have more. Did that all fit in that box?
Oh, well, no,
that
right other rats. So that was the con haul. Any other exciting con stories? Anything...
Well, I mean,
was it worth the trip?
Oh, always, every time, yeah. I love going there.
Cool.
Yeah, for sure.
Got some pretty nice books.
Yeah.
Can we say what con it was?
Steel City.
Steel City Con out in Pittsburgh. Yeah.
Yeah.
So
August
you like that?
2019.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I think they have it every 3 months, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they'll be back in December.
Yeah. And who do they have lined up now for this?
I didn't even see yet.
I know if I would have went to this one, they had X-Pac was there. From Degeneration
X.
Yes. I saw Honky Tonk Man was there as well.
The Honk. Cool. See, I got that WWF blank variant so I could get signatures. I think the first person I want to get to sign though is RVD. RVD shows up at this a lot.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll get him to draw me a little pot leaf on there or something.
Very cool. Very cool.
But, all right, Dave. Nice haul.
Yes.
What do you think is the best one you got out of there, the whole haul? What's your favorite one?
I'd say this guy right here.
You like the Immortal Hulk one?
Yeah, I think that's really cool.
Oh, man, I like that Venom Codex.
Mm-hmm. I like that one,
that's
too.
Purdy.
That's
Boom.
Nice.
Boom. All right, man. I guess give Dave a like over, what is this?
Twitter.
At Twitter?
@vanilla_fingers.
There you go, guys. Thanks for joining us. That was Nerdfinger's Steel City Con haul for August of whatever year this is. I can't keep up.
2019.
And I guess we're going to Nerdcore out. Dave?
Nerdcore out.
Boosh. Cool.
If I had the power to gather all of my favorite MCs with the illest comic book characters and they became arch enemies. Inconceivable, unbelievable, yet as wild as it seems. The Emperor and Stan Lee would coach the two opposing teams. Keep it clean, move back.